What's up, family? This is Terrion Wilson for Investment Blast. I need you to go to investmentblast.com. Just check it out. I think you might like it. For those that want to subscribe to Investment Blast, just go to the description, click that link, put a little information in there, and you'll be all subscribed and ready to go. Now, if you haven't subscribed and liked the video on YouTube, I need you to do that. Only takes a second. And then hit that little bell that lets you know when the video comes through so we can stay connected and you can get this great game. Now, today I wanted to hit you with a nice quick one. This is about the whole Monique situation with Netflix. Monique thought she got lowballed from Netflix to do a comedy special. Netflix offered her a purported $500,000 to do her Netflix stand-up special. And Monique wasn't happy with that at all. She didn't think that's what she was worth. First of all, I'm going to give a little black background on Monique. Great comedian, actress, one of the best comedians ever in the history of comedy, if you look at it. A lot of people might try to disagree, but when they really look at the landscape and look at black female comedians, you're going to put Monique near the top or at the top most of the time. And if you go back and just look at the stuff she's done over the years, you will probably put her there. Now, she's also did great stuff in the community. She's made multiple stances for her people and her opinions. She was wronged in the whole Precious promotion situation. They tried to slander her, drag her name through the mud. Even Tyler Perry admitted that he was wrong about the situation. You have to give her props on that as well. She's been unfairly treated to a certain extent, in my opinion. Now, that's just my opinion on that situation. So let's get to some of the particulars of the situation, though. Netflix reportedly reached out to her to do the special, and then the offer was $500,000. So let's take a look at some of the things Monique is saying. So Monique is saying that, you know, Dave Chappelle, Chris Rock, they're getting $20 million per special. And she also pointed to Amy Schumer getting a certain amount of money for her special. So we'll look at Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle first. So these are legends, you know, no doubt. Even if you don't like some of their jokes or some of their specials, you can't disagree with the fact that they are comedic legends and they are ingrained in that landscape. I believe they deserve the $20 million per stand-up, per special, I should say. Because of the things they've done, the resume stands on its own. Now, I'm just gonna set them to the side. We're not even gonna make it about them. I'm pretty much gonna keep it on Monique, and I am gonna bring up Amy Schumer, and it's a reason why, because Monique is claiming racial and gender bias. So, is it racial and gender bias? Probably. But let's look at it from a different angle. So let's look at Amy Schumer. Amy Schumer reportedly got $11 million for what she deemed the leather special. I guess that was her comedy stand-up special. So let's look at Amy Schumer. Amy Schumer has been a stand-up comedian for years. She had her own TV show for a little while. She's done a few movies, and she, you know, she's a pretty funny lady, I would say. Not really my cup of tea with that type of humor, but, you know, she has made me giggle, you know. I saw a movie she did called Trainwreck, I believe. That one was okay, you know. The problem with Amy Schumer, in my opinion, with Netflix, you know, offering her the $11 million is that she is in comedy circles. She is accused over and over again of stealing jokes. If you don't believe me or if you think I'm playing around, I need you to go to YouTube, punch in Amy Schumer steals jokes. And you'll see a bunch of stuff. You'll see compilations where people put the comedian up there to tell the joke and then show Amy Schumer doing the joke later in almost the exact word-for-word joke. And she did this over and over and over again. Now, am I saying it's 100% that she's stealing jokes? I don't know. But, you know, yeah, more than likely, If you tell the joke the exact same way, the same setup, same punchline, I'm not a expert in being a comedian, but it, you know, it's like, duh, you know, something's going on. That, I think, should take away from the $11 million. I think her offer should have been a lot lower. Now, it's reported that she was offered $11 million, but she went back and renegotiated and got more. And she renegotiated because of Chris Rock and Dave Chappelle's deal. So, if that is true, that she got more than $11 million for her special, she's known in comedy circles as being an alleged joke stealer. And then you take Monique, who is one of the best comedians in the world, I think way better than Amy Schumer, in my opinion. I've never heard her being accused of stealing jokes, and she was offered $500,000. You need to, there's something else going on there other than you think Monique is worth that. Now, can it be a situation where a continued blackballing on Monique? It could be, but I don't know. So we'll just set that aside. We'll just look at the facts here. So let's take Monique. Monique has won an Oscar. She's been in multiple comedy specials already, stand-up specials. She has also made some great movies. She actually did some free concerts. You know, she's done a lot of stuff, man. And $500,000, a lot of people are saying, oh man, just take the money and all this and that. But I'm kind of siding with Monique on this one, in that she deserves to get more than $500,000. I think she's worth more than that. And Netflix supposedly told her it's not about resume, and then they touted Amy Schumer's resume as a justification for her getting what she got. You know, that's just game. You know, they was giving Monique game. They was just telling her something to get her off the phone, in my opinion. Yes, Monique is worth way more than $500,000. To those that say, you should have just took the money, whatever. But I think that she's very bold in her stance, and I think it's not really about the money. I think she's trying to blaze a path and just point out that this bias is hindering, you know? And I think she's trying to open a pathway for those that coming behind her, some of those young, you know, female comics that are coming up, that one day, you know, the tide will be a little more even. Because you can't take somebody that's known as a joke stealer and then give her way more than somebody that you know is doing stuff organically and is a lot funnier. And I think she got lowballed. And I totally stand with Monique. In my opinion, not a lot of black people are gonna, you know, stop their Netflix accounts, in my opinion. But I stand with her and what she's saying. And I want, you know, in the future, if I have a daughter, I would want her to be, you know, paid what she's worth. So I totally understand the situation. Now, let me break down a couple of things. Netflix right now is worth about $261 on the market. Now, I spoke on this before with the H&M thing, but the only way to really hurt a company like that is to hurt their stock price. You get it to the point where they're not making as much revenue, then that can affect the stock price ultimately if people stop buying and, you know, and they just start selling the stock that they have business. Now, when they start selling the stock, makes the stock price go down, that's when you put a hurting on their pockets. I will run through a couple of things that I would have, you know, taken into account or thought of if I was her to do. Now, a few options, in my opinion. One of the options, which, you know, I'm just throwing it out there, but you could have took the $500,000, gave the best show in your life, talked about the Oprah situation, all the situation, even with Netflix, right? It would have ended up well for you if you would have got a lot of viewership. Then Netflix would have came back to you trying to re-up, you know, and then that's when you hit them with, gotta give me that, gotta break bread now. Or, you know, a better option, in my opinion, is leveraging it, you know, leverage. Everything in negotiation is about the leverage. If you have no leverage in negotiation, you're going to get lowballed, and more than likely a deal won't get done unless you take something lower than what you deserve. Now, if you go in with leverage, especially if you go in with a lot of leverage, then you're going to get closer to what you deserve or more, you know. So some leverage could have been an HBO, Showtime. You could have actually did the special with them or just got an offer and then went back to Netflix and said, hey, they're willing to give me this. Hey, you know, I'm telling you, it's going to be the best show ever. I'm talking about Oprah. I'm talking about these things. Whoop, whoop, whoop. And if they don't want to deal with it, just go ahead with that other place and rock out with them. Because if it's a big enough special, Netflix is going to come crawling back to you. Or the third way you could do it is just do it yourself. You know, that's one option that I look at when a lot of people get into these situations that they don't really take into the account, is that you can do it yourself, man. The way media is set up now, the way things are going now, I don't think it would take that much to set up your own special. You can even hire a director like Spike Lee or something, throw them a couple of dollars. I'm sure he'd do it, right? You give him enough money, man, he'll make that sacrifice and do it for you. Back in the day, Keenan Ivory Wayans, I think, if I'm not mistaken, he directed Eddie Murphy's Raw, you know what I mean? So, you know, that's not out of the question to do it that way. You rent out a venue, you know what I'm saying? You put somebody on promotion, you hire somebody for that, you hire somebody for this and that to set it up, and then you hire a real deal director, man, and you just do it yourself. I mean, it's going to take some, you know, planning. It's going to take some money. Might take a lot of money, but on the back end, you know, you're probably gonna reap more than you sow, right? So at the end of the day, those are my three suggestions that she could have went down those roads, or still can go down those roads. But at the end of the day, no matter what I'm saying here, I'm agreeing with you, Monique. I stand with you 100%, sister. We need to build our own infrastructure on everything, including media. So you're more than welcome. I'll direct your show. Don't forget to go to crbtees.com. That's crbtees.com. That's where I got this. See that? I woke up like this, black. Go there and, you know, support them. They're great. crbtees.com. You should see that somewhere around in there. Or is it there? One of them. All right. Peace.